Problem 54 on page 13. This is an interesting problem involving manipulating the numbers for delta H, delta G, and delta S. A certain reaction is non-spontaneous under standard conditions. Under standard conditions, that means the little symbol there, G, delta G is positive. That's what it says. However, it says that under high temperatures, degrees Kelvin, G becomes negative. So how could that be that it becomes spontaneous under higher conditions? Well, if you look at the equation, you can kind of figure out what must be going on. You've got in this equation delta H minus T delta S. So here we have numbers, basically two terms. This is a subtracted term, so it's the same thing as adding the opposite to this whole thing here. The delta H has got to begin at least positive, and it'll always be positive. Once it's positive, the temperature doesn't affect the delta H at all. And since we're starting out with a positive delta G, like it says here, we realize that we're going to add that to a negative term, but this term here has to be smaller than this. And so under low temperatures, T being very small and delta S being somewhat positive, delta S has to start out positive, because that's the only way that this would be negative. But if this term is smaller than that term, it can still be positive. However, when you increase the temperature here, if you make the temperature big enough, then this small positive number times a large temperature makes this term here, negative, very large negative. And when you add that to a smaller positive, that throws delta G into the negative form. My conclusion, therefore, is that for a certain reaction to be non-spontaneous under standard conditions, but spontaneous under high temperature conditions, the original state had to be delta G was greater than zero or positive. Delta H had to begin greater than zero or positive. And also delta S at least had to begin greater than zero too. And it's only when the T gets large enough that the opposite of that sign makes this term large enough to compete in addition with that term to throw this negative. So all three were greater than zero to start with. And when I look at the problem, it seems like the answer is C.